when I'm reading something, I do it in a very similar way in that there's like, there's foundational things that you're never going to persuade me to believe. Like, for example, in my content, I'm never going to cuss. Like, you're just never going to hear me say a cuss word. I'm just, it's just, no, there's nothing. Gary Vee does it and he's very successful at it. It's just not going to be my thing, right? That's like, it's not something that, or I'm never going to insult my audience. Like, hey, welcome you all, you stupid. Like, I'm never going to do that. Just, and it's just like, there's these things that are deep beliefs with inside of me. If we're talking about the frame of content as profit, or there's these deep beliefs about like that Messi has about soccer and like, I've been playing soccer 20 years. I'm not going to do this differently, but I will listen to new strategy. If we're talking football, I can take Tom Brady from the New England Patriots and put him on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And the offense may be different, but there's fundamentals to the game that are never going to change. And you can take those fundamentals in 2020, and then you can look back in time to like 1890. To give you an example of what I mean, there's a book. Now, this is a heavy book. I don't recommend this to anybody that's like just getting in the game of reading, but it's on Andrew Carnegie. It's the most, I think it was published in 2014, and it's called Carnegie. Andrew Carnegie is one of my favorite entrepreneurs of all time because he's got this amazing quote. He says, I'm going to spend the first half of my life building wealth, and I'm going to spend the second half of my wealth giving it all away. And that wasn't just lip service. That's what he did. Have y'all heard of Carnegie Hall?
Yes. You know,
like the big, that's him. Carnegie Library, that's him. There are people in 2020. Now, Andrew Carnegie, I think he died like in 1901 or something like that. I remember. He died over 100 years ago. People are living on a pension that he established. He knew he wasn't going to, he knew he was dying faster than he could give away all of his money because he made so much money. Isn't that a great problem to have? I'm in for that problem, right? So he was dying faster than he could give all of his billions away. So he established a pension. People are still living off of that money today. That's how great the guy was. But to give you like a full circle on your question of like, how do I read books and like filter out the information and like what's true, what's not true, because all these people are successful. Even back in it was during the Civil War. So it was like 1865, 1867, something like that. It was like before then, but he had bought some stock. Now don't get too caught up on like the details. The principle is what we're going for. So he bought some stock. The stock paid a dividend, which means it pays him income just for owning the share, for investing in the company. And he got his first dividend check. He was like 16 years old. He got his first dividend check and it was like $25 or whatever it was. And he, it was like if he had an iPhone, he would have like texted his buddies, mind blown. Like that. He couldn't believe that he invested in a company and he got a dividend. Like they sent me, I gave them money and they're sending me money back. And I'm going to get this like every month or every quarter. It was like, he couldn't believe it. And there's this great quote in there about like what he was telling his family. He's like, I can't believe, and he had made good money as an employee, like trading time for money. But the dividend check of like, I totally forgot I invested in this company and the money just showed up. Like that was so mind blowing to him that he built his entire life on that. So there's, when I'm reading information, there's these principles, there's these foundational things, like I'm going to seek income that doesn't require me to be there. It was mind blowing in 1857 to Andrew Carnegie. And it was mind blowing to me at 23 years old when I first had my rental property. My mortgage on my rental property was $971. The income check that I received was $1,350. So it was like almost like a $400 profit. That was so mind-blowing to me that for the rest of my life, I'm going to commit to mailbox money. All of my time is going to go to that principle. The same thing, because that's time-tested. So I'm looking for those frameworks. I'm looking for that. Charlie Munger is another guy I mentored with, and I'll wrap this up. But Charlie Munger is another guy I mentored with. He's a co-founder of a company called Berkshire Hathaway. Mm-hmm. Most people don't know that name, but they do know Warren Buffett. That's his co-founder. Charlie calls them mental lattice works. It's a way that you look at the world that's like based in reality. And if it doesn't measure up against this lattice work, then you discard it.